What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Pedal Steel Every Day. It's day 478, and today's video is all about customizing my brand new Pelican Air 1745 case for my Sho Bud pedal steel guitar. I recently removed the pick and pluck foam, and I'm excited to share the detailed process with you. So let's dive in. The foam in this Pelican case was incredibly easy to work with, allowing me to create a customized fit for my steel guitar. It's a major upgrade from my deteriorating original case, and I can't wait to put it to the test after an upcoming fly date. Stay tuned for that update. Now let's walk through the step-by-step process of customizing the foam for my pedal steel. Step 1, aligning the instrument. The first step in customizing the foam is aligning my steel, pedal rack, and steel legs and pedal rods with the closest foam squares and rows in the new case to match the original case's orientation. This ensures that my steel sits securely and is protected in the case. I find it helpful to have the steel upside down, allowing me to easily screw in the legs while it's in the case. Step 2, marking the corners. To mark the corners of the steel in the foam, I'm using some extra pedal board patch cables. While the instructions recommend toothpicks, I didn't have any on hand, so this is a simple and effective alternative. By marking the corners, I'll have clear guidelines for cutting and shaping the foam. Step 3, measure depth. Next, I measure the correct depth needed to secure the guitar in the new Pelican case. It's important to minimize any play of the steel, ensuring a snug fit. I take into consideration that the half of the guitar with the strings needs to be deeper in the case than the armrest side. This way, I can prevent any potential damage during transport. From my measurements of the original case, the side with the strings on it measures 7.25 inches, so I'll use this when I go to pluck the foam out of the new case. Step 4, removing the foam. Removing the foam to match the dimensions of the steel guitar is a meticulous and time-consuming process, but it's crucial for achieving a perfect fit inside the case. With a steady hand and precision, I carefully remove the foam, making sure to go slightly beyond the actual size of the instrument, which I marked using the patch cables before. This extra allowance ensures a comfortable fit without exerting any excess pressure or compromising the protection of my pedal steel. I use my fingers to delicately peel away the foam, following the guidelines I made earlier with the patch cables. It's important to work slowly and double check my measurements to avoid any mistakes. As the foam starts taking shape, I periodically place the steel into the case, assessing the fit and making any necessary adjustments. This process requires patience and attention to detail, as I want to strike the perfect balance between a snug fit and ease of removal and placement. By meticulously removing the foam to accommodate the unique contours of my pedal steel, I ensure that it will be securely held in place and safeguarded from any potential damage during transportation. It may be time-consuming, but the end result is a custom foam interior that perfectly cradles my instrument, offering optimal protection and peace of mind. Step 5, accommodating the pedal rack and legs. As I continue the process of customizing the foam, I carefully adjust it to accommodate the pedal bar rack and steel legs. These are crucial components of my pedal steel, and it's essential to create suitable spaces within the foam to securely fit them, just as the original case did. By carefully shaping the foam around the pedal bar rack, I ensure that it's snugly held in place, preventing any unwanted movement during transportation. The foam provides a cushion and protected environment for the delicate steel legs and pedal rods. I carve out precise grooves and slots to hold them securely, minimizing the risk of any potential damage. This meticulous attention to detail ensures that every part of the pedal steel is properly safeguarded in the case. Now, I can have peace of mind knowing that my pedal steel is protected and will stay in place, no matter how bumpy the journey may be. With the foam perfectly contoured to accommodate these components, I can rest assured that my pedal steel will arrive safely at the destination, ready for me to hit the stage with confidence. Step 6, securing the wires. This might be a completely irrelevant step for you if you don't have any loose wires on your pedal steel, but to ensure the safety of the electrical wires from my recent pickup swap, I tape them down securely. This prevents any potential snagging or damage if the case were to be searched by TSA during air travel. It's always better to be proactive and take precautions to protect your gear. Step 7, checking the clearance and security. After shaping the foam, it's crucial to check the depth clearance and security of the case when it's closed. I want to make sure that everything is properly aligned and that the case can be closed without any pressure or strain. This step ensures my pedal steel is well protected and won't shift during transportation. Step 8, adding an ID card. Adding a business card to the outside of the case in the included ID card holder is a smart move. This way, if my case ever gets misplaced or lost, there's a way to identify the owner. It's a small but important detail to protect your gear and increase the chances of it being returned if it's ever separated from you. Leaving extra space on the right side of the case without removing foam provides flexibility for future use. In my old case, I used to keep one of my instrument cables in that space. However, since I have the Steeler's Choice seat, I can store the cable there, eliminating the need to risk removing any more foam from the Pelican case. But I'm open to suggestions from you, my awesome viewers, on what I should use that space for. Let me know down in the comments. And there you have it. My Pelican case is now perfectly customized to fit my Sho Bud pedal steel guitar. I'm confident it will provide protection and security I need for my upcoming fly gig. Before we wrap up, I want to ask you for your tips and advice on flying with a pedal steel. I have an upcoming fly gig, and any insights you can share would be awesome. Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for joining me on day 478 of Pedal Steel Every Day. Stay tuned for more exciting updates, and as always, play every day.